I guess. And so for no reason, now I'm in a parking lot. I don't know. I don't get it. I mean, it makes sense where I was on a street, because I was just in a building. And so buildings are usually near streets. But I was out in an ice field, and now I'm on a... Well, I don't know. I guess maybe the ice could have been on top of other shit. Like, maybe it was on top of a road, but... I certainly was not indoors in a garage. But now I am. So... By now, you pretty much get where this game is coming from. You've seen most of what this game is going to offer. There's going to be a lot more different enemies coming up later, but this is pretty much how this game works for another, I don't know, however long it takes me to beat it. Probably another 45 minutes. So let's see. One of the things I really like the music in this game. I find it's really cool. Some of the music kind of reminds me of Mega Man in a sense. Kind of has some cool, interesting beats to it. But mostly rock-oriented. It's like most of Mega Man is kind of rock-oriented. Even though it's 8-bit, so it's not all that sophisticated. But, the thing that gets me is that there's like, I don't know, how many songs are in this game? There's a few. There's a good handful or so of songs in this game. Pretty much all of them are just blatant remixes of trying to make songs out of the Ninja Turtles theme. So there's that one iconic Ninja Turtles theme that we all know from the cartoons and everything. And it basically took that and turned it into 10 songs. So this car is about to come out and hit me in the face. Along with these guys with guns. I've never seen guns that have, like, big fucking lips like that on the end. Have you? I don't know what's going on. Look at this. Sometimes you can hit a guy, like, the hitboxes are weird. Sometimes you hit a guy, and it seems fine, but he still fucking hits you with the edge of an attack that doesn't make sense. Like, the guys with the guns, and some other guys are probably later. Especially annoying with bosses, because bosses do, like, way more damage. Anything else. So like every time you get hit, you're like almost dead, so it fucking pisses me off. There's another one on cars. Jump to avoid it. Hey, look at me. How am I supposed to avoid all this shit? It's ridiculous. But once again, my super special attack saves the day, kills enemies from any trajectory. That's the thing, that's one of the reasons why this Donatello is best turtle in this game. Because of he has the longest range. So I'm pretty sure that applies to the special attack as well. So you do the special attack, and for like a half a second, anything that's in range of you is instantly dead. Which is awesome. It's a totally overpowered attack. But it's not so overpowered because it's kind of hard to do it. These guys are kind of different because they have ninja stars, but they look exactly the same as the other ones. Probably throwing you for a loop until you get hit in the face with one. With a shuriken. So now here's, Baxter? Whatever the fuck he is. This is one of the more annoying bosses. It's really hard. There's a rhythm that you can find where you can hit the guy and avoid all of the shots. But it's tricky. And he's all over the place. So maybe I can get it. Damn it. Nope. Because you're trying to jump over the attack while still hitting them like this. I can keep this up. Because if I can keep this up, I can just stun lock him and he'll be dead. Damn it. I messed up. I'll get the pizza anyway. Just in case. Oh, he's dead. Why would you put April right there? Like, you're just coaxing me. Damn, she got some big-ass boobs. Look at that shit. Now I'm gonna show her how turtles do it. You bet you owe me one. I got one for you right here. So now, since we were in a garage, now we're on the highway. Which which I guess makes more sense than the last transition. And now I have April, which doesn't mean anything, except to move the story forward. Now, I'm not sure, but this music for this level doesn't seem to have any correlation to the typical Ninja Turtles theme. It seems completely different, like completely original. And it's really cool. I like it. And these are one of the more annoying foot variations with the spears, because they do the thing where the hitbox is really weird and stupid. Like, even you can hit the guy, and you'll get hit by the... Oh, I'm an idiot. I forgot about the car. These guys are sledgehammers. Fucking pulling a Triple H on my ass. It's time to play the game, motherfuckers. Literally, because I'm playing a video game. Kind of meta. Kick all their asses because they're fucking slow as shit. There's more of these bots. Which I always thought they were kind of annoying, but they're not really. Especially when you could do that. You just... fucker. As long as you don't get hit by the laser towel wire of death, then you're good. You can just stun lock them. Not get hit by the laser. It's pretty easy to dodge everything. The hard thing is just catching them, because they just all over the place. They run around. They're maniacs. More dynamite. They're actually easier than the other regular putty. Or, I keep saying putty. Power Rangers is awesome, I guess. They're around at the same time. And, the same years. And they were marketed to the same people. So, what? I don't know. And they look the same. Look at them. They look exactly like those putties, don't they? I guess before they changed them, because they used to look really weird. Almost like ninjas. But then they, like... I don't know what they did to them. It looked even weirder later, where they were all one color. They didn't have a weakness before, but apparently, like, when it came out with the second, like, later on in the series, they had a weakness, but they were still harder for some reason. You just had to hit them in their weakness. Which is apparently not as good. Apparently that's better, that's worse for some reason. I don't know. I don't know what a strategy was with her. It was really weird. Oh, I can't believe I got hit by the car twice. I'm so stupid. That is a big... Oh, God. I want to get hit by the atomic bomb. Why are they carrying these giant bombs for? It seems very dangerous. You'd think a bomb like that would have a much bigger explosion than just that little web. The little explosion from the bomb is even smaller than the size of the bomb. It makes no sense. There's another instance where if you want to farm points, you could do so, because if you stay right where I was before, they will infinitely spawn. And just keep killing them, get as many lives as you want. Until you run out of patience. Which I did after killing one. And I don't need it anyway. Totally fine. Hell, I'm probably gonna get another point, another life, either at the end of this level or in the next level. So I'm good. Still got 3 left. Haven't died yet. Killing all these Triple H inspired foot soldiers. The giant sledgehammers. Which sledgehammer, in all fairness, it does a lot of damage. But you're supposed to play this game, you're supposed to constantly be moving. You're never supposed to stop. And actually, they don't really... The way the enemies fight, they don't really want you to fight them like in their face with your regular weapon. They discourage you from doing that, because if you do that, you get your ass kicked. Unless you're playing with a friend, and even then. Because, I mean, look, I hit the guy, and they get stunned for a second, but you can't hit them again. They have that little invulnerability thing that Mega Man has. But you can't see it. It's not obvious. It's not clear. You just have to discover it by hitting them, and then you're still, like, smashing the button trying to hit them, and they don't react. They just punch you in the face or grab you. So you're just like, well, what the fuck? I was totally hitting you, and you didn't do anything. And realize that there's, you know, a hidden invincibility lock in there so that you can't just fucking wail on guys infinitely like that. It's clear on the bosses, because the bosses flash when you hit them. So now, I pull out my skateboard for some reason. Because everybody else is using them. I don't know. I don't know why I couldn't use them before. And I gotta kill all these other guys on skateboards. Apparently the skateboard is sentient. It can read my mind and go exactly where I'm going. I'm getting fucking stunlocked by these assholes and it's pissing me off. But thankfully, I shouldn't have to worry much about it. Because this level is pretty short and there is no boss. So, that should be fun. I hate boomerang. Look at, what sense does it make for the boomerang to hit me in the face and then I get launched forward about 30 feet into a wall? I don't know. Look, I didn't even fucking, I'm not even hitting anything that's damaging, but I'm getting launched back 20, 30 feet by bullets that are 10 feet away from where I hit. I mean, look at it. The fucking hitboxes are ridiculous. It's not like, oh, you're hitting the propeller. No, the propeller doesn't do any damage. What are you talking about? So that's the end of the level. It's pretty short. As much damage as I was taking, I didn't really have to worry about anything because it was so short. So I'm going to hop in the van, which I don't know why I couldn't have done that before. And April doesn't know how to drive. Women drivers, am I right? Fucking threw us off of a bridge. And not only we totally wrecked our car, but they stole our pig in a blanket, aka the Splinter. Who doesn't look like a Splinter at all right there? He just looked like a pig. A pig wrapped in a burlap sack. So depressing. That's our mentor. No more foot. The thing that's weird is, so, the turtles, they got mutated by some crazy slime, I guess, and they just became like ninja warriors, right? Which, I mean, first, like Splinter was supposed to be a ninja warrior, which is why he's their mentor, but he's also like super intelligent or something. But it made sense why he was a ninja warrior, because he was the pet of the Splinter. Or not Splinter, he was the pet of Shredder. Or whatever the fuck his original name was. Before the accident happened, where he got his face got disfigured. So, if it made sense for Splinter to get mutated and inherit the martial arts powers of the Shredder, because the Shredder was like a great martial arts guy, then why are the turtles such great? They were trained by the Splinter. I guess that makes sense. But they've like usurped him. I guess because he got old. But how much time is taking place? Like how fast is he aging? I don't know. Maybe he was old to begin with, I guess. Maybe he was like a 20-year-old rat. And he just finds these mutated turtles. And he's like, you know what? I must pass on my teachings, because I have a beef to pick with my former pet owner, who apparently now is angry. I don't remember what his motivation was, because I remember him being disfigured in that movie by Splinter when he was still a little rat. Why, I don't know. I think he was going to kill him, maybe. And he was like, no, I'm totally going to defend myself, you punk bitch. And so he scratched his face, and he's like, oh, I'm totally gonna kick your ass now. But, he got away. So now, these are the most annoying ass enemies in the entire game. Bar none. These fucking robot dogs. Or whatever the fuck they are. They shoot the same lasers that fucking Bebop was using at the beginning of the game. But now there's constantly three of them. And you die in two shots, but god damn it. Kind of hard to dodge shit that's all across the entire fucking screen for like 10 seconds. And it pisses me off. Thank God the nightmare is over. Getting slammed against walls like a boss. So I think I'm about halfway more than halfway through this game. Shouldn't be too much longer. The game goes pretty fast. But, yeah, most of it is just kind of fighting these guys. Like, how fast can you kill all these guys that are coming at you? Because the levels are pretty short. Just gotta fight like 100 guys to get there. So I'm whacking these guys off one by one. No problem. Here's something weird. I don't know if it's just me, but you know how, like, the graphics in the NES aren't so great because it's old? It always looked to me that the turtles, that they didn't look like they had eyes. It always was like they're just a cyclops. Just one giant eye blinking every now and then. It's totally a cyclops. Teenage Mutant Ninja Cyclops. These guys aren't so bad as long as you don't get hit like 10 times like I'm doing right now. Because I'm a fucking idiot. So they die pretty quick, and you gotta fight another swarm of them. I think it's just two flying around like jackasses, completely aiming with no regard for human life. Or, well, I guess I'm not human, so no regard for turtle life. I was saying it's kind of weird. This is Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles. You know, teenage, but I don't know. Are these turtles actually teenagers? Or are they just some kind of weird hybrid between... Because I guess they're supposed to act like teenagers, like teenage humans. They're anthropomorphic. But I don't know what's going on. I mean, turtles live a long time. Like, they were really tiny, but they could... I don't know how turtles work. How big they get. What species this turtle was. Right now... I guess I'm just trying to focus on not dying. Because that would be a huge upset. Because I know, it's like, as soon as I get to the end, there's going to be a slice of pizza. And I can fight a boss. And the boss is going to be really hard. No! No, you fuckers! I can't believe this shit. I'm going to fucking die. I'm going to get pissed off. Because I'm going to have to fight this boss. And I'm probably going to die against him too. And I can't afford to do that shit. This is the best security system ever. It never attacks you. Yay, pizza. Level 1. This guy just jumps out of the fucking sky, out of heaven. I don't know who this guy is supposed to be. Like I said, I don't know shit about this series. All I know is this game kicks ass. And there's a Splinter tied up on the side. There he actually kind of looks like the Splinter. Before, when he was being carted off, he kind of just looked like a pig in a burlap sack. But now he kind of looks like... Star Fox, I guess. But this is way before Star Fox came out. So this is where it gets... This guy takes like a fuck ton of hits. And up to this point, most of the bosses have been pretty easy. But this guy is pretty vicious. If you're standing away from him, then he'll fucking torch your ass, and that does a lot of damage. And if you want to hit him, every time you hit him, he goes to punch you. So you have to jump up, like, immediately, like, the second that you hit the ground, you have to jump back in the air. And the timing's really hard, and usually hits me a lot of times, and... I don't know how many times it takes to hit him. You gotta hit him, like, 50 times. So it's like this point forward, where they kind of, the game is, it gets really hard, as if they designed it specifically for you to play with, because you're supposed to play this with a friend, like two-player co-op, and it gets a little hard for one person to get through these odds. Like, I guess you're supposed to, like, you know, cross streams, kicking the guy with a buddy, or you just, I don't know, maybe you just alternate. One guy hits, one guy dodges. He's almost dead, you can tell because he's flashing. It's one of the best mechanics I know of. Oh, my first death. I fucking hate it. And he didn't even hit me again. That was complete bullshit. And now he turned into a big flaming pile of dog shit. Literally.
God, you look like shit.